time to be in the presence of God. Hallelujah. What a joy to be in the presence of God. Hallelujah. What an honor to worship our Lord. Hallelujah. For He is worthy of all our praises. Hallelujah. The moment we come up through that door, we experience the power of God so much. Hallelujah. That's only my desire, that we will experience the power of God. Hallelujah. That is what is different about our group, Pentecostal group. That's the only difference, is the power of and the presence of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. I am so excited to share with you what God has put in my heart. When Pastor asked me last week, a few days back, if I would speak at the English service, I responded by saying, if you believe in me. So basically what I'm saying is, I really don't, so most of the time, I don't trust myself. I don't believe in myself. But I know there's a God who believes in me. Hallelujah. There's a God who believes in each one of us. Hallelujah. It is not because of our merit, but it is His grace. And the message and the power is from Him. Hallelujah. We are just like those empty, microphone or whatever. You know, the message comes from the Lord. And I'm so humbled that I could speak the word of God. Hallelujah. We are, you know, when we think about that, who are we, Lord, that you're so mindful of us? All I want to do is just fall down at His feet. And I feel like that's all I want to do, is just fall down at His feet and praise Him and thank Him for all He has done. Hallelujah. This today's Psalms reading was such an encouraging. That is the message that God has given me, actually. So He already shared half of the message, and I thank you, Pastor. Also, thank you, Sister Elsama Isaac and Pastor John Isaac. Thank you for joining us, and welcome. Praise God. Hallelujah. Let's turn to Lamentation chapter 5, verse 21. This is what the Lord has put in my heart. Hallelujah. And I believe there is a message for each one of us. Lamentation chapter 5, verse 21. Somebody please read it for me.
Bring it back to you. Give us a fresh start.
Yes. Hallelujah. It says, bring us back to you, O Lord, right?
Give us a fresh start.
Give us a fresh start. Hallelujah. Or it says, restore, another version says, restore us unto you, O Lord, so we can be restored. Give us a new beginning. Hallelujah. God wants to give us a new beginning. God wants to change the image of some of the people in this church. God wants to change the image of our church. Amen. The message God gives us today is, restore us back to you, Lord. That means, you know, when we talk, look back to our little bit background about this in Lamentation, we know it is said that this book is written by Prophet Jeremiah. Prophet Jeremiah, he is called a weeping prophet. And if you look at Jeremiah chapter 1, it says, chapter 1 verse 5, it's a prophet's call to Jeremiah. It says, before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee. And before thou camest forth out of the womb, I sanctified thee. And I ordained thee as a prophet unto nation. This is so encouraging to know that even before you were born, even before I was formed in my mother's belly, God knew me.
Amen.
God anointed, God has a purpose for every one of us who are called by His name, that even before you were born. That means it does not matter what your ability, what your strength, what your education, what your character, what your ability or your position. What matters is God has already ordained you before you were born. Hallelujah. How many of you are happy? So when we go through difficult times, that is the promise to hold on. God, I know there are times there are difficult times and challenges in my life, but I know the calling that you have put in my heart, that you have called for me for a special purpose. And what is the purpose in our lives? Is it to become doctors, engineers, teachers, scientists? Is that really the purpose of God for us? What is the purpose of God? Hallelujah. God has set you, sanctified you. He has ordained you, hallelujah, as a prophet to the nation. We are in this dark world. Each one of us is called a light in this world. There are people around us so dark in the darkness area. God calls us to be a light in this world. Then he says, the little boy, who is Jeremiah the prophet, he says, but then, oh Lord God, behold, I cannot speak, I'm a child. And many times that is our thinking. What can I do as a little young person, as a young woman, as a young boy? What can I do, Lord? You know, people are critical of me. Jeremiah had to face a lot of criticism. People did not accept him. He was a weeping prophet, but he did not give up. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There may be criticism around you. There may be people may gossip about you. There may be pressures against you. But remember, God's calling on your life. Don't give up. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Even in the dungeon time, even when he was in prison, you know, some of the things that I see among our youngsters, you know, when we go to like those outreach ministry, you know, every one of us are, before we go, we all are afraid. But when we get there, especially when we went to the Jean Green park, when we went there, oh my God, the youngsters were running around. They would not even slow down. They were so enthusiastic about giving tracts. I had to stop many times. I can't get names shared. What I mean is, God has put visions and now hearts. You wouldn't know until you step into faith. When you step into faith, that's when you know. That's what Jeremiah says. If I don't preach, if I don't share the word of God, it's like fire shut up in my bones. Hallelujah. I thank God for the calling. Okay, back to the words. Lamentation chapter 5, verse 21. This is a situation, if you know about Lamentation, or it's called a weeping, book of weeping, a cry. All five chapters, there are five chapters there, you will see it's a cry of the people, the Jewish people that were, when Babylonians came and destroyed the temple and the Jerusalem, the people are weeping. But in the midst of that, in chapter 3, verse 21, hallelujah, somebody read chapter 3, verse 21, God is giving you hope. There may be situations or situations in our life that we feel that we have lost. I'm on Lamentation chapter 3, verse 22. God is giving you hope to the people of Israel. Hallelujah. The mercies of the Lord, because of his mercies, we are not consumed. But because of his mercies, hallelujah, God has compassion. His compassion does not fail. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness, O Lord. Hallelujah. It's not because of our merit, our strength. We have fallen many times. There are many people, many of us, are sometimes go through difficult times, we fall and we get up. It's the grace of God that we are able to rise up. And God is still giving you hope. Jeremiah says, verse 4, the Lord is my portion, save my soul, yet I will hope in him. That is the greatest hope we have, that our God is our portion. Hallelujah. You know, this book, Lamentation, is related to Deuteronomy chapter 28. Now, when you think about when Hallelujah. people of Israel from the bondage, from Egypt, they were delivered, and God made a covenant with them that they will be inheriting the promised land. And as they are walking, Deuteronomy chapter 28, it talks about God brought them out of bondage, and God tells them that if you follow the law, if you obey my commandments, and if you follow, you will receive the blessings. Next chapter, it talks about if you do not follow and obey my commandments, then it lists a lot of curses there. All these curses will come upon the people. And we know the people of Israel, they came out of the bondage, but for 40 years, they were going round and round in the wilderness. They are not able to inherit or reach the promised land. There are some times when we don't obey the Lord, what God has commanded, or what has God called us for a special purpose. And what happens, we end up in wandering in the wilderness. It may take years where it should have been much shorter time, but sometimes it takes years and years. But then there is a group there, another generation rising up. Hallelujah. I mean, they have seen these people, their forefathers wandering in the wilderness, who will not be obedient. But here, let me remind you this morning that you could be at the border of your promise.
Amen.
But if you miss the voice of God, or you take it for granted, sometimes we have so much meetings and so much of church that we take it for granted. We don't want to hear the word of God. Hallelujah. We get so excited that we could miss the promise. You may be at the border of getting your promise, but I want to encourage you this morning that know that, you know, you can be at a place, if God has promised something for you, it is, if God has told you promise, I thank God, He's a God of promise. He keeps His promise. Hallelujah. We are His children. He keeps His promise. Now God is in a situation where these people, they are not obedient. They are going round and round. God cannot give the promise to them. Now God is in a situation. What do I do? He is still a God who promises. So He is looking for people who will be obedient to God. Hallelujah. Two young men, they rise up. Hallelujah. Joshua and Caleb. Hallelujah. God is looking for a Joshua generation who will rise up and believe that what everything the Lord has promised.
Amen.
You know, this generation may look different. This generation may not follow the protocol. Yes? This generation may not dress like everybody else. This generation may not know the language. This generation is born in the wilderness. They're not born in Egypt. This generation is different. They look different. They dress different. They talk different. But God does not look at the outside. And God looks at your heart. What is your thirst? Are you thirsty for the Lord? What is your desire? Are you willing to believe everything the Lord has promised? God is rising up an army, a new generation. And God is looking for you and me, each one of us.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Who is willing to accept? And the Bible says, believe. You know, Jesus told a verse to Mary. Didn't I tell you, Mary, that if you believe on the Lord, if you believe, you will see the glory of God. Hallelujah. If you are a generation that believe on the promises of God and willing to pursue and stay and obedient, God wants to restore everything the other generation has lost. Everything the other generation who is dying in the wilderness. Here is a generation that is perishing in the wilderness. But God is looking for an army that will rise up and willing to take the stand.
Amen.
And willing to move forward. regardless of what the circumstances is, regardless of what the situation is, regardless of what the criticism is. God is looking for a generation that will inherit the promise. In Joel chapter 2, it says, I will restore your ears that the locust has eaten and the cranker ones. I will restore the time that you have lost. Maybe you have lost few years in your studies. Maybe you have lost few years in your Christian life. But God said, if you're willing to step up, I will restore those times. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise God. If you come back to the first love, God said, if you do not, I mean, remember the days. This morning, this verse was so encouraging. You know, Pastor was reading from Psalms. How can it be quiet? How can I stay quiet? He has turned my mourning into dancing. He has turned my sorrow into joy. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
How can we stay quiet?
Yes.
When I come to this presence of God, all I want to do is, if I could jump, I want to jump. If I could run, I want to run. There's so much joy that's bubbling in my heart for all the Lord has done in my life. The joy that he has put in my heart. Nobody around the world, if you look around the world, there are people in turmoil. There are people in distress. They are worried. But the word of God is so powerful. Every day they are new, every morning. Hallelujah. You know, sometimes, I thank God for the word of God. Sometimes we go through, you know, one morning I was waking up with fear of Ebola. You know, everybody is talking about Ebola, and my son is in New York, there's an Ebola case, and I was just so worried and anxious. But then here comes the word of God, like a rainbow word. Jason normally usually don't put those words on group. Here comes the words that say, don't worry about today, for today will worry itself. You know, God has a promise. That, you know, that verse enraged me so much. Sometimes you don't know what you post on the group me, but it is for somebody. So keep doing what you're doing. Thank God for the young people that are so active on GroupMe and putting those verses. So many times has been encouraging in my life. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
But God is raising up a generation that will take hold. And don't be ashamed. Hallelujah. And to sing and dance for the Lord. If you will honor God, God will honor you. Hallelujah. You know, the years that you have lost, God is willing. God is able to give it back. We must have a warrior mentality. You know what a warrior? We know the spiritual battle. Hallelujah. David one time, and I know Pastor touched on this also, but where David was in a crisis one time. He lost everything. He lost his possession. He lost his family. David was in a crisis. He didn't know, and it says he cried until he had no power. He cried so much until he had no power. And he asked the Lord.
Hallelujah.
He asked the Lord, should I pursue? And the Lord said, hallelujah. God's plan for you is not to give up, not to settle for anything less. Know the plan and purpose for your life.
Amen.
Don't settle for anything less when God has a higher purpose for you.
Yeah.
In a situation in this world, and David, it says, he encouraged himself in the Lord. Lord, at times there may be nobody around you. Your friends may not encourage you. Your church may not encourage you. But you got to find that relationship with the Lord. That's why it's, you know, it says, return us to the Lord. Not to anybody else, but to the relationship. Back to our relationship. And I want to say, this is a promise from God that this is a time where he's going to restore your image. Your situation, your ears that God has, you know, you have lost. The shame, the embarrassment, the problems, what you have lost, your finances, your health.
Amen.
Hallelujah. God wants to restore those ears to you. But don't settle for anything less. If you will turn with me to Judges chapter 9, verse 8 onwards, we see the story of the trees, they are looking for a king. Can somebody read those four few verses?
Hallelujah.
Let me read myself. Judges chapter 9, verse 8. You know, this is the story of the trees, that all the trees get together and they're looking for a king. The trees went forth on a time to anoint a king over them, and they said unto the olive tree, rain thou over us. There are trees in the forest, and the trees are telling, we need a king over us. And they go to the olive tree and say, hey, olive tree, can you be our king? And olive tree says, but the olive tree said unto them, should I leave my fatness, wherewith by me they honor God and men? Olive tree is a very strong tree. I don't have time to explain all that. But it refused, and it said, I'm going to be promoted over the trees. No. Verse 10, and the tree said, then they would go to the fig tree. Come thou and reign over us. But the fig tree said to them, should I forsake my sweetness and my good fruit and go to be promoted over the trees? He refused too.
Hallelujah.
He comes to the vine, the trees unto the vine, come thou and reign over us. And the vine said to them, should I leave my vine, which cheereth God and men, and go to be promoted over the trees? All these trees refuse because they know what they are made for. They know their purpose.
Amen.
You youngsters, and you know, we need to know what God's calling in us. Don't go to every little bitty party and every fun things around the world. There are so many attractions around the world. There are so many sins that will allure you, that will call you, come, be our king, be in our midst, but know your purpose. No, you are supposed to bring sweetness to the Lord and to the people. But if you go and be a king over those trees and try to, you know, dance over the trees, you are losing your purpose. When all the trees gave up because they knew their purpose. We know we're just talking about Abimelech. I am not going into the details, but then here comes a little bramble. That's a creepy vegetation, I would say. The bramble said unto the tree, you know, I'll be the king and I will give shade. But you know what? And it is relating to Abimelech. We know that there are people that are weak. There are people that does not understand the purpose of God in their life. They will go for anything. Be careful. When circumstances, when sin calls you, they will knock at your door. Sin will come again and again. You will think one time, I got victory over this. No, it will come and knock at your door again. You will fall in the circle again and again. Be careful who you are, what you are called to be. You're called to bring sweetness into the church of God and to the people and to the people around you. You are called for a special purpose. God said, I will restore the time that you have lost. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Many times, hallelujah, people call you, well, what are you going to do? Especially this generation, you know, the generation that have fallen, who's been going in the wilderness for 40 years, 40 years, they've been in the wilderness, and they are dying right now. Those are the people that will rise up and say, hey, what are these people doing?
Hallelujah.
What are they doing? They don't understand.
Amen.
But God is looking for a generation, a Joshua generation that will rise up. Hallelujah. They are called the Y generation. They are called the Z generation. People call them weird and wired and weird and all those. But basically, these are the people that will... God is looking for them to rise up.
Hallelujah.
And take your stand. Hallelujah. The generation in the wilderness, they may not understand everything that's going on. Paul says, they're in the wilderness, they may not understand, they may not fit with everybody in the world. Paul says, I'm pressed on every side, but I press forward to a goal. We have a goal in our mind. Hallelujah. We are pressing forward. Pushing aside every struggle because I'm a child of the wilderness. I may be in the wilderness,
amen,
but I'm trying to find my way. All we see around us is sometimes negative energy, haters around us, jealousy around us. But that God has put a vision in you. And all this happens is because of your vision. You know, people may not support you. Hallelujah. But believe on the Lord and you will see the glory of God. Can you be the people that will say, I am pressing forward to the goal? Hallelujah. I am shaking up my pain. Hallelujah. I'm trading my sorrows and I'm taking the joy of my heart of the Lord. I am willing to pursue. And I don't know how negative our situations may be, but I am staying in my place and moving forward. Hallelujah. Every lie that Satan has spoken upon us, every gossip, every circumstance that has come against us, God is saying that you can claim those back. God wants to give you back the time that you have lost. Hallelujah. So you can get into the purpose of God. Revelation chapter 2 verse 1. One more. Before we close, can we read Revelation chapter 2 verse 1? Chapter 2, verse 4, 5, 4 and 5.
Nevertheless, I have this against you, that you have left your first love. Remember, therefore, from where you have fallen, repent and do the first works, or else I will come to you quickly and remove your lampstand from this place, unless you repent.
Hallelujah. God is asking if you have fallen. There are some areas that you may feel that you have drifted away from the Lord. God is calling him back. He wants to restore the image in your life. He wants to restore the power in you. Hallelujah. The Holy Spirit power. And he wants to bring you back to the first love. Hallelujah. Don't compromise with the world. Don't settle for anything less than what God has already did for you. In Isaiah chapter 45, it says, I'm going to do something new. Afresh, something new. We have been hearing that since yesterday. Hallelujah. A new promotion, a new blessing, and new doors for you. And that is our promises for today, is God is going to do something new for our church. New for each person, each one of us, for our families, for our church. God is going to change. And if you believe it, take it by faith. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. When you believe, you will see the glory of God. Hallelujah. Amen. New boldness, new anointing. As we were singing, hallelujah. Every chain that the enemy has put, it's broken. God is rising up a generation. Hallelujah. And how many of you want to say, I want to be part of that generation, Lord. I want to be part of that. I want to be a partaker for that, Lord. I don't want to settle and die in the wilderness, Lord. I want to take part. Hallelujah, and be partaker for the glory of God. Thank you.